Okay, dear friends, we continue. Şimdi I was talking about the if you observe any leakage, I open the pencil also. If you observe any leakage on the hatch cover, what should you do? Şimdi at first, what I recommend you, if you will load any water sensitive cargo, okay, before going loading port, it is better you make your own test, okay? So I changed the pencil. Yes. For example, grain cargo, any grain cargo or any steel product, fertilizer, something, anything, any water sensitive cargo. Şimdi you can make several tests when you are making the checking the hot conditions. The basic is the visual check. Okay. Visual check. Why it is important? Because if any structural damage, any crack, anything, if you observe, you can understand with this one. Each kind of test have different purpose. And then you can make chalk test. Chalk test. We apply chalk on the compression bars, all the surface, and then we close the hatch cover, open again, and we see on the rubber packing if any missing compression, less compression, we observe with this one. This is another thing. So, for example, if any spot here or any liner like this, so you can also understand with this one. But don't forget, any less compression doesn't mean have any leakage. So you have to make hose test. Hose test or ultrasonic test. Generally, company doesn't send the ultrasonic test device on board. So most probably you will not able to make this one, but you can make hose test for the leakages. Okay. So when we make hose test, for example, for that hold, we found some problems like this. Okay, I clean here. Okay, so what does it mean? What can we do in that condition? For example, one by one, why there is any spot leakage here? Any spot leakage here? Any problem with the landing? Because this is landing pad area, correct? Any problem with the landing pads? Any problem with the, for example, your compression bar, some have waving something around that area, any problem with the compression bar, or maybe your in your rubber packing some any gap, small gaps if have that area. So according to problem, the solution will change. Okay, if any problem with the compression has to be filled here. If any small gap, okay, we can put one small rubber packing to complete here. But any problem with the landing pads, maybe you have to put some shim plate, something, anything you have to observe. And then we actually, this spot leakage is not a very big problem. Okay, because the leakages in the spot leakage is less than the liner leakages. The most the big problem is the liner leakages, okay, the big liner, because too much water can enter the cargo hold from that area. One by one, we solve that spot leakages, okay. So if any problem with the compression bar, we fill. Any gap between the rubber packing, we fill. Also any problem with the landing pad, okay, we just make minor adjustment with the what was the name, the landing pads, okay. So yeah, this one, but this one is up to you. If you have too much spare and if you have time, okay, you just what I told you, instead of small, you just cut one big rubber packing, the 1.3 meter, and then completely renew that area, also completely renew, okay, if your problem with the rubber packing. Okay, here we solve that spot leakages, and then we come to liner leakage. Okay, why there is a problem here? Şimdi in the liner leakage, if the liner leakage on the side of the hatch cover, it is problem. Why? In case it is on the sides, one option, first option, you change all the rubber packing, changing rubber packing. For the liner leakage. But if you don't have time, if you don't have any spare also, the other solution is for the liner leakages, long leakages, okay. Second solution is the fire hose solution. Okay, so what is the length here? For example, let's say 5 meters. Okay, we just, you know, the fire hose is round, but when it is empty, it is becoming like this. Correct. Huh. Not cut from the middle. Directly make it double like this. And make it exactly like this. And what is the length here? Okay, 5 meter length. 5 meter just cut. Completely put that area. And when you close, there will be no water enters. Also, for the spot leakages also, spot, some small pieces of rubber hoses you can fix here with adhesive glue, multi-purpose glue you can use for that one. But if you make this one, when you go to port, if somebody come to check your rubber packing something, if they make in any preloading survey, it will be problem. That is why if you make any adjustment like this, okay, any unofficial things like this, your company has to know. Okay, the other solution, okay, you observe this one and company told you don't touch the rubber packings, so what can we do? Some smalls, okay, some missing, some gaps between the rubber packings, okay, they will not tell you not put close here, you will close. But for fire hose business on the sides, for the liner leakage, maybe they will not want this one. So what can we do? We can request expandable foam. Expandable foam. So for 56,000 dead weight Panamax, 5 volt Panamax. Okay, so it is about 25 bottles. Expandable foam. This is just a general rule. Okay, yani one carton, it is about 25 bottles. So each hold 5 bottles. But don't forget, this application is depends on the crew to crew. Some crew is very familiar and can quickly make very good foam application, but some of them not familiar, so maybe 5 bottle is not enough for one cargo. It depends on the crew to crew. Okay, the other solution is Ramneck. Ramneck. If your company, for the sites, okay, I open the photo. Where is the photo? For example, yes, here. For example, that area, this underside of the hinge of the cargo hold, you cannot apply Ramneck very easily. Even if you apply, maybe it will not good. So it is better for the sides, all of the sides. Okay. Apply foam, expandable foam. But for the top area, for the cross connections, it is better apply to Ramneck on the top. Okay, so this is another solution. But when you take photo of the condition, when you prepare report about the hatch cover, at first confirm which method you will apply. You will change the rubber packing, or you will apply foam, you will apply fire hose, you will apply Ramneck tape. Which one you have to determine, and this one has to be confirmed with the company. Okay, normally. And then If you have liner leakage in the cross joints, okay, in the main connection of the hatch covers. So what can we do? For the sides, nothing to do. You will change the rubber or you will apply fire hose, okay. Or. Also what I remember, for the spot leakage or for small liner leakage, you can apply the rubber sheet. Rubber sheet. Yeah, we speak before, for the manhole we cut black color rubber sheets, natural rubber sheet, correct. Huh. You just cut some length, okay, put that area instead of fire hose, maybe you can make this one also, okay. But for the side also maybe you can make this one instead of fire hose, you can use if you have enough, okay. But for the middle, at first, before apply, you can solve with fire hose, you can solve with rubber packing also, but before apply anything, or maybe you can change the rubber packing change, okay, you can make also this one, but these are long. What I recommend you, in case the liner leakage in the cross joints like this, okay, here, that area. So, pardon. In that area, okay. So, what can we do? Do you remember the locators here? We have locators on the sides of the hatch panel. Şimdi, what is the liner leakage mean here? Maybe, one option, your rubber packing is damaged or old, too much permanent set. But, if your rubber packing in good condition and still you have a liner leakage in that area, means your hatch covers not touching each other properly. So in that case, you only one side, okay, don't forget. Only the pushing side, okay, also have some locators like this, okay. So what I recommend you, only one side from the pushing side, only here. One shim plate here. One here, also one here. So if you make that area thick, so it will just little push your hatch cover. So what I recommend, but this shim plates not more than 2 millimeter, not very thick. Okay, so 2 millimeter from here, 2 millimeter from here, it will be total 3 millimeter, 4 millimeter. More compression each other. So in your, if your rubber packing in good condition, but you still have any liner leakage in the middle, so okay, just weld shim plate to locators, okay, and then make the test again, okay. So most probably your liner leakage will be no more. Ha, if you have, okay, you have liner leakage, I draw again, I erase here, we have liner leakage in the middle, and then we apply some shim plating to the locators, and then we observe, we make the test, and then we see, okay, or liner leakage, maybe it is better I make like this. This is old liner leakage, very big, okay, and then we apply the shim plates to the locators, and or liner leakage become too much less, maybe have small leakage also, maybe some spot leakage here, or maybe just little remain in that area. Ha, in that case what you can do, okay, here for that spot or small liners, fire hose, rubber, natural rubber sheet, okay, you can make this one. Also one option is changing the rubber itself. It's up to you, but the best way is the natural rubber sheet if you have, okay. Yeah, they not recommend, but I already show you the photo here. But for this fire hose, we change the photo if do we have. You see here, you will put the shim plate on the locators. Ha, normally when you put natural rubber sheet as back strip. Yeah, normally we have to remove this one and then underside of this one. Maybe I change the color, it is better. we remove this one, completely remove, for example, like this, we remove. Underside in the rubber channel, we apply the natural rubber sheet and then we close this one again with the all-purpose glue. But if you don't have time, okay, nothing to do, you just directly apply from the outside. Sometimes nothing to do, okay. If you have time, make. If you don't have time, nothing to do. But don't forget, that is why I am telling you, before arrival, in sufficient time, you make your own check, own report about the hatch covers condition, and you make a quick plan, and you proceed for the solution. If you make from outside, natural rubber sheet, or if you make any fire hose, or if you have any gap here, you fill the gap with small rubber packing. And when you go to port, if somebody see this one, yeah, it depends on the condition. Sometimes they care, sometimes they don't care. Okay. So actually, it will be affected also if when you go to loading port, if some third party surveyor come or they come from port, make ultrasonic test, and if have any problem, they will tell you, oh, what is this? But if no problem, nobody will tell anything. Okay, so it depends on the condition to condition. But official way, completely remove, completely renew the rubber packings. But sometimes don't have time, so we must need to make some unofficial solutions for that problem, actually. Okay, so yes. So how many ramnek we will use? I want to tell you. For the ramnek, şimdi I am always talking about the 5 volt, 50, about 56,000 dead weight bulk carrier and Panamax. Okay. So I already told expandable foam. Foam is 25 bottle. But okay. But for the ramnek. Şimdi one name is ramnek tape. The other name is hatch cover, sealing tape. It depends on the name depends on the IMPA or ISA. Okay. Name changes, but the same tape. So how many will request? Maybe your company tell you charterer want to, sometimes charterer want, even if your cargo holds in good condition, you make hose test, no problem. And they make ultrasonic test, also no problem. But sometimes charterer or owner want additional protection. Okay. This additional protection, no problem. Because their choice or cargo holds in good condition, cargo hatch covers, but they make additional. Okay. So if they ask you, okay, order how many ramnek tape? The ramnek tape size has to be 150 millimeter, 10 meter length, 8 pieces box, and total 9 box. Okay. But for the safety margin, maybe you can make this one 10 box. 10 box. Okay, so this is the ramnek tape, the width 150 millimeter, the total length pieces, one roll, one piece, 10 meter. And because they roll this one like this and put in some carton boxes like this, 4-4 and coming like this. And then underside same also, like this, so total. They make 8 pieces. 8 pieces box. So total 9 box or 10 box. Because if it is better you make 10 box. Why? Because maybe you need to apply additional ramnek for the ventilation lower, Mechanical ventilation flap something. I show you the photo before. If do we have? Neyse, anyway. So this is the quantity you need. So, but how will you apply the ramnet? Okay, one option. How if the weather is hot, everything is good, no rain, no humid. Okay, with the torch. Okay, with torch, hand torch. Hand torch. What is this? It is just something like this. Coming. There is a case here. The handle like this. And small tubes. Okay, like this. Here is a pin. With the screw, you fix the tube from here and you burn the torch and you apply to ramnet. So you make it soft and you can easily. Okay, for example, this is my hatch cover. This is the cross connection. I apply the torch to ramnet or the steel itself. If the weather is hot, okay, apply the steel. If weather is not hot, directly apply the ramnet and put the ramnet here. And with the wooden hammer, I just push the ramnet. Okay, this is one thing. If the weather is cold, what we will do? This is hot weather. Hot. If the weather is cold, one option. Epoxy thinner. Epoxy thinner number 10. But this number 10, I don't remember if it is for Jotun or Hempel. I don't remember, but I remember it was for Jotun. Okay. So, yeah, you can find the same number for the Hempel also, for the epoxy. Because, you know, for the epoxy thinner, what was the number? Thinner number, what was the name? I think this, yes, yeah, this is for the Jotun thinner number 10, but epoxy thinner. Okay. And okay, what we are doing in that case, this is my hatch cover, this is the cross joint, with hand roller like this, small finger roller, okay, small roller, paint roller. I just only one time, okay, one time apply to steel plate sides, and then I open my ramnet tape also, only one time, just by hand, only one time, not too much. If you apply too much because it soft too much also ramnet, it is another problem. Only one time here, one time here also, one time with ramnet, and then directly put the ramnet here again, and then with the wooden hammer, you fix the ramnet. If you don't have, if you want any original product, what is the original product name? For ramnet fixing. General purpose primer. Okay, primer for multi based compounds. Okay, these are 4 liter tin. So total 14. Okay. You will request this one, and with the paint roller you will apply this one. Same here, but this one no need to apply to ramnet. Only. This is your hatch cover, cross joints. Okay. You just apply the cross joints directly with the paint roller, and then you put your ramnet with the wooden hammer. Okay. You fix the ramnet. This is the method. Okay. This is another method. Okay. So. Okay, we continue from the report. Yes. What I want to tell, if the weather is rainy and your hatch covers are wet, you cannot apply ramnet. With any method you cannot apply, nothing to do. Okay. So this is one of the statistic with the DMV statistics. Okay, the hatch cover problems on the vessels. They make some statistic like this, but you can read the document. Okay, I am just proceeding. I want to come another point, important point. Hatch covers due diligence. Şimdi, I am telling you the unofficial methods because you know, sometimes don't forget the golden rule for the hatch cover rubber packing. What I told you for the windlass brake lining pads. If your brake lining pads are very old and need to change, if need to change, nothing to do. You cannot escape anymore, okay? Change. But if have still in fair condition, okay. Because not change, because this is as much as possible, try to escape. But if it is time to change, don't escape, never escape. Same with the hatch covers. Hatch cover rubber packings. Rubber packings. If you need to make, if you can solve the leakages with shim plate, with some small rubber packing applications, with some, I don't know, the natural rubber sheet with the fire hose, something, you can solve with small tricks, okay. As much as possible, you make this one. But if they are in very poor condition, if it is time, come to change, nothing to do, you must change. Okay. But changing of the hatch covers is very big business, actually. Because when you open the hatch cover, there is the photo here, which is clear here. Because, you know, here is rusty. Rusty. Also, when you remove the rubber packing, you will see here, is the rubber channel, correct? It is, how can I draw? This rubber packing go inside the rubber channel on the hatch cover. It is going down and like this, it's proceeding all the way. So I draw this rubber channel. This is my rubber channel and I will put my rubber packing inside this one. My rubber packing is coming like this, correct? Huh. So this area also will be rusty. So at first, before change, so what I told you in the beginning, the deformation in the rubber packing is a sign, is not a problem itself generally. So if you, okay, if you determine, you will change at first. If any mechanical adjustment need. So if you need to adjust the locators, maybe some repairs on the landing pads, something, at first finish the mechanical repair and then you have to remove the rubber packing and then you have to derusting, chipping the all the way of the rubber channel. Okay, you clean that area, you make derusting, chipping, and you apply primer to not become rusty again, and then you fix the new rubber. Otherwise, if you not make mechanical adjustment and if you not apply primer again, derusting, chipping and primer again, when you fix the rubber, you will see sometimes it, for example here my rubber channel, it will loosen again, or you will reduce the lifetime, pardon, you will reduce the lifetime of the new rubber packing because maybe some over compression, some problems with the landing pads, okay, so you will damage the rubber packing very quickly again. So it depends on the condition. Actually, if you have time, okay, you change. If you don't have time, nothing to do. Just directly remove the old one, put the new one. Sometimes nothing to do. I remember I was second mate. In 12 hours, we change all the rubber packing in one of the hatch cover. But it was not a good seamanship. Good seamanship, actually. We just change, directly change, nothing to do. But it is not a good practice, actually. And one of the golden rule about the hatch cover rubber packing, pardon, changing, I want to tell. Here, I open the page again. I explain here because it will be much more easy. Yes. Here, I just make it bigger. Okay, you determine, you change. But what is the golden rule for the changing the hatch cover? Okay, we continue. Şimdi when you change the hatch covers, I draw with green color. Şimdi what is the golden rule? Şimdi normally when you can change during the navigation, If weather permits, okay. And if your cargo not sensitive, the best cargo for hatch cover rubber packing change is sand cargo sent. Okay. Because sand not sensitive for the water also. Even if you open, even if you remove the rubber packing and water go inside, it will be no problem. Okay. It is already wet. So you observe the cargo. In which cargo you will change the hatch cover? Ha, in empty condition. If you have long time, it is the best. Because okay, after clean the cargo holds, after discharging, okay, you can make change. But in that case, maybe if some sea spray some come, it will go inside the cargo hold. Maybe you have to rinse again with the fresh water. Okay, but the best cargo is the sand. Okay, and if the weather permit. And second thing, when changing, the golden rule, one time change and finish. Okay, what I recommend, for example, for that hatch cover, okay, what we can do, at first finish the centers and then go for the around, or at first go for the around and then finish the centers. Cross joints, okay, this is the way. And then when you start changing, okay, for example, change like this, change one panel, you proceed panel by panel, okay, change this one and then this one and then this one, okay, so not completely remove all the rubber packing at the same time. All the panels. Just proceed panel by panel. Okay. For example, at first, I finish the cross joints. All the panels. Okay. And then I, for example, this is forward. This is aft. Panel number one, number two, number three. Okay. At first, I finish the sides. And the aft. Say forward. Okay. I finish this here. And then I proceed the second panel. Okay. I finish the sides. I finish. And then I proceed to last panel. I finish sides and the aft. Okay. One by one you proceed. And the best thing is for one panel. For example, in one day, if you change the sides and the aft remain, so here is new packing. Here is new packing. Here is old packing. This is not good also. In one time you start early, remove all the rubber packing, everybody, but all the deck crew, okay, very quickly, there is chipping here and primer, there is chipping primer, there is chipping primer, okay, we finish before the noon and then we wait for dry up until 15 p.m. okay, 3 p.m. and then after 3 p.m. okay, we start putting the new rubber packing. Okay. This is the way. And first day, for example, first day I finish the center. Second day I finish this one. Third day I finish number two. And the last day I finish here. One by one proceed. And proceed from the forward holds. Okay. This is my vessel. This is the forward. This is hold number one, hold number two, three, four, five. Actually, if you need to change, okay, you make your own test and several leakage in all of the hatch covers. So, but your spare is enough only for two hatch covers. Okay. Which one you will change? At first forward holds. Okay. Hold number one and hold number two. Because sea spray much more coming, these two hold. Maybe until the half of the number three also, maybe. But generally they give you only two spare, enough to change the cargoes. Instead of starting aft holds, at first finish the forward holds. This is the golden rule. Okay. This is also another important thing. And then okay. So how many minutes this one? Okay, we just can continue here. And the main problems. Şimdi I want to speak about the main problems here. Common mistakes, okay. Insufficient knowledge about the hatch covers. not allowing for good inspection and proper understandable reporting. Şimdi normally don't forget, this hatch cover maintenance is a specific job, okay. Actually, for example, when you go to load any break bulk cargo, işte hot coil, cold coil, mixed steel product, something, it is a profession, okay. You not generally face that kind of loadings. This hatch cover inspection also another knowledge actually. Normally what you should do, company agree with some third party company, they come on board and they check the hatch covers and prepare a professional report, normally like this. But yeah, we speak about several things around here. You can make also, but it will be not very very good. Same like them. This is one of the problem on the industry. The second problem, our estimating the capability of the ship's crew repairs, maintenance and adjustment. What I told you before changing, you have to adjust the mechanical damages, any crack, anything, any adjustment with the landing pad, any adjustment with the locators, something, any problem with the hydraulic. Okay, because ship's crew is limited, so their working capacity is limited in one day. Okay, maybe you start changing one of the hatch cover and then maybe the voyage change, something happens, something, you don't able to change all the hatch cover rubber packing, something. Maybe you don't have time to make repairs because ship's crew is limited person. So we can make some job in basic time is limited. So, but the, you know, all companies always push the vessel, make very big repairs, Actually, it is overestimating the capacity of the ship's crew. This is another problem. Okay. So, but in that case, in somehow, anyway, you, if you must change, okay, time to come change and company told, okay, change. At first, make very, very good planning. Okay. Visual inspection. And then chalk test. And then hose test. Okay, and then make a report, hatch coming by, hatch coming, hold number one, işte hatch cover number one, two, three, four, five, one by one, okay, here have liner leakage, here have spot leakage, okay, how we solve this one, hold by hold, you prepare your report, submit the company, and then preferably start from the forward holds, one and two, if any repair or change, okay, this is the other important thing. Very very good planning. Make your plan, all the details, and then you just suddenly start and quickly finish. This is the rule. Okay. Overlooking the importance of involving class when ship repairs, shipboard repairs are carried out to hatch covers. Don't forget what we tell. Hatch covers maintenance is a load line business. Okay. Not only for cargo. Because this affect your sea worthiness. Okay, if you make any repair on the hatch cover, actually you have to involve the class. Okay, this is also another thing. When you make any repair and you, if you didn't record this one, and when class surveyor come on board for any reason, for any check, and if they realize this one, maybe it will be problem. Okay, this is also another thing. Improper or temporary repairs by crew. Yeah, it's actually depends on the conditions. If you have time, make official solutions. Official solution is mechanical adjustment. And then completely changing of rubber packing. Okay. And involve the class for approval. Okay. But 99% we don't have time. Nothing to do this one. We are making temporary, improper, unofficial tricks we are making. Nothing to do this one. Actually, this is a management problem, not ship's crew problem. Okay. This is management problem. So if company told you, okay, make temporary repair, make temporary repair. If they told you, okay, don't touch, we will involve the class. Okay, involve the class. This is management problem, not ship's crew problem. Okay. Missing manuals and drawings. Yes, this sometimes can be. No onboard instructions for maintenance. Yes. I want to speak about this one. No onboard instructions of maintenance. In one of the vessels, Company sent one message to fleet vessel, and they face some problem. You know, this is the hatch cover, operating panel have some leakage, have some problem, so they couldn't able to open the hatch cover, and then some off hire on the port. So they sent all the fleet about that problem, and then they warn the vessels. Okay, but when they send the message to the vessel, normally, you know, when you send any vessel, any message to vessel, you send message to the master. Okay. And master receive that message, he give chief officer or chief engineer, according to department. Okay, but the when you write a message to vessel, it must be master, okay. But they send that message to the directly chief officers, okay, directly. And then our master become too much angry actually about this one. Pardon. Yes, we have time, okay. And then he didn't reply the message. İşte 2-3 days, 5 days pass, and then he told me, okay, write a message about this one. So, what is the no maintenance files on board, hatch covers not including in SMS, okay. No maintenance instructions also. These three are together, okay. Safety management system, PMS system related with safety management system, onboard instructions and maintenance is related with the PMS system. So, yeah, I write a message about this one. I told them, okay, deck crew not make visual inspections and also not make the not observe the operational conditions of the hatch cover. And then engine crew not make the technical inspections. But on the other hand, in your PMS system, there is no instruction for the maintenance and the repair about the hatch cover operating panel. Okay, this is also important thing. Okay, so if it is not included in your PMS system, you warn the company. Okay, because if it is not included, it is not your problem actually officially. Because PMS system must include all the parts of the vessel. Okay, if it is not included officially, it is not your problem anymore. It is the company's problem. Okay. And then, okay, we continue. Understanding of the due diligence principles issues. Yes, yeah, as much as possible. Yeah, we are going, okay, I am telling this is company problem. But anyway, we are going on board. We work on board. We go on board, not the tell excuse. We go on board to make solutions, okay. But as much as possible, we can do, what can we do, we will do. But don't forget, it is, if any problem, when you go on board, when you see hatch covers, very poor condition, not feel yourself guilty, okay, it is a management problem, don't forget. Okay, directly check the PMS, if PMS is included, but where is the records? If the records are fake, why? Okay. And you know, every 6 month period, superintendents come on board to make intermediate inspection, işte annual inspection, something like this. When they come, why they didn't check? This is also another problem. Actually, this is in major parts, in cranes, okay, in hatch covers, in main engine, something. If any problem, if big problems, don't forget, always related with the management system. Okay, not the ship's crew fault. This is another thing. Okay, my friends, we continue with the next video.